Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today we have with us the Chevrolet Tahoe. Now the Tahoe is very popular in the Middle East and in the US, and this one, the brand new 2021, has been built with a lot of input from customers across the world and with the design team from Chevrolet. Now what we have today is the Z71, which has been designed specifically for off-roading, because like you know, we are in the desert and people love to do bash over here and go off-road. Now this car comes with a 5.3-liter V8 producing 355 horsepower mated to a 10-speed transmission. Now this is a Z71, like I said earlier, and this is designed specifically for off-roading. You can see the complete blacked out trims over here with the blacked out hood, red toe, the toe hooks in case you want to get yourself pulled out or winched out. So this has come in red, and the complete car has a blacked out setting. The Z71 has a 34.9 approach angle, which makes tackling dunes much more easier and doesn't damage the car as well. And talking about the earlier blacked out bits, it also has an attached steel sidestep, which makes getting in and out of the car easier, and doesn't have the retractable one, which actually makes it more better for off-roading. Another cool bit about this car is that it has a Chevy logo inside the tail lights. You know, giving it those small touches is what makes a car stand out, gives it personality. The interiors of the Tahoe are pretty decently built. They have come with leather interiors in the top trims and fabric in the base ones. It's a nice place to be. It's pretty comfortable, it's spacious, it's very big and very broad. This car is actually bigger and wider and slightly heavier than the previous version. It has 5 screens, obviously the big 10-inch screen over here, another display, a digital display, and a heads-up display in the front. It also has 2 screens at the back, which can be casted from your tablets and phones. So the people at the back can actually remotely cast whatever they want to watch onto their individual screens. Another new feature on the new Tahoes are the button gear shifts. So in the older ones, you would have the gear transmission, which is the stick transmission, the column shifter, which was used to be over here. But in this, you can see they have buttons over here, which you can engage P, reverse, neutral drive, and low range gearing. All the off-roading buttons are on the left-hand side, and this is for your climate control over here. Let's go check out the backside now. The back seat of the Tahoe is a great place to be in. You have a lot of space. 3 adults can sit very comfortably. You can spec it with captain seats as well. Again, looking at the big display at the back, it has rake, so you can adjust it as per the light and as per how you want to look at it. If you're smaller or shorter, you can adjust the screen for yourself. The seats can be folded and recline as well as per your comfort levels, and they can slide as well, so you can store much more stuff at the back and give the back occupants much more leg room as well. And when I'm fully taking the seats in the front, there is still enough space for me. I'm not a tall guy, around 5'8", but this does it for me as well. Coming to the rear bench, now this is quite spacious enough for me, and I wouldn't mind sitting over here for a long journey. The biggest advantage of the rear bench is that the suspension has been moved a bit on the side from the older versions because the car has become broader. This frees up space at the back seat, at the rearmost bench, which makes it a proper 7-seater SUV. So if you have a large family, you should definitely consider buying the Tahoe.